Okay, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to actually watch a patient scenario here and then kind of talk about it as a group. Sound like a plan? Let's see if I can turn on this video. These are some videos of some patient scenarios that are actual real scenarios here.
Linda Brooks?
That's me.
Have a seat, Linda. My name's Nikki. I'm one of the nurses. I need to ask you a few questions about what brought you here today. You're having some belly pain and bleeding?
Yeah. It's not really pain. Mm-hmm. It's like cramping up on me, like I have my period. I thought maybe I was pregnant because I skipped a period.
Okay. How long have you had this cramping?
It started about 2 hours ago. I was sitting watching TV and it just came on kind of sudden.
Okay, on a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being the worst pain you could imagine, how do you rate this cramping?
About a 5.
All right, and you're bleeding?
It started spotting in the morning, and now it's like a heavy period.
Have you passed any clots?
No.
Okay. When was your last normal menstrual period?
It's been a while. Let me see, maybe 7 or 8 weeks ago.
Have you ever been pregnant?
No.
Okay. Any dizziness?
No.
Okay, good. How old are you?
23.
Any medical problems you see a doctor regularly for?
No, I'm real healthy.
All right, do you take any medications?
Nope.
Any allergies to any medications?
No.
All right. I just need to take your blood pressure and put this thing on your finger.
Laura, abdominal pain with vaginal bleeding is a common chief complaint in women of childbearing age. The cause can range from an ectopic pregnancy to a spontaneous abortion to an irregular menses. In order to decide the acuity level, it is important to look at the patient. This healthy 23-year-old female does not require immediate life-saving interventions, so she does not meet criteria for ESI level 1. The question becomes, does she meet criteria for ESI level 2? And the answer is no. She is awake, alert, oriented, her pain is 5 over 10, and her abdominal cramping is generalized, lower abdominal pain. Her skin is warm and dry, and she has experienced no dizziness. No indication that she has an ectopic pregnancy. The triage nurse feels comfortable that she is stable to wait in the waiting room. So moving on to resources. This patient will consume a number of resources. She will need labs, an IV with fluids, an ultrasound, and perhaps IV pain medication, two or more resources. So she will be assigned ESI level 3 after the nurse looks at the patient's vital signs and notes they are within normal limits. If the patient's vital signs fell outside the accepted parameter for this age, in this case a heart rate greater than 100 or a respiratory rate greater than 20, she could up-triage her to ESI level 2. If she was hypotensive or significantly tachycardic or had impaired mental status or was hemorrhaging that necessitated the need for immediate hemodynamic interventions like fluid resuscitation or blood, she would meet criteria for ESI level 1. This is a good time to talk about the patient who presents with abdominal pain. Most patients with abdominal pain will be at least ESI level 3, consume many resources, labs, IV with fluids, IV medications, and a CAT scan. The elderly, patients in severe pain or abnormal vital signs would meet ESI level 2 criteria. The need for hemodynamic interventions would make an abdominal pain ESI level 1, requiring immediate life-saving interventions. Okay, so let's stop and talk about that for a little bit. Do you guys have any questions about this scenario?
Mr. Humphrey?
Oops, didn't quite get that off. Any questions about that one? What do you think?
Pretty straightforward.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I thought it was pretty typical of the patients that present an RED and the types of things you assess, the types of common interventions.
And her color looked good. She was fairly animated. She even smiled in conversation with the nurse. Mm-hmm. So, and she didn't have any unilateral pain or anything indicative of an ectopic. So I'd feel comfortable that even if she's pregnant, she's relatively stable.
Mm-hmm. We get a lot of patients asking about that ectopic, or a lot of nurses asking about that. They want to make that complaint at a level two because of an ectopic. But she really doesn't. I think you said, go ahead.
Right. I was going to say she looked too good. I mean, her pain level was low. Mm-hmm. She interacted well. Her color was good.
And her vital signs were certainly appropriate.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep. Generalized abdominal pain, as you said, not localized abdominal pain. So good.
Sounds like you guys got it.
Yeah, we agree that it was a level three.
Oh, good. Mm-hmm.